Yeah, welcome student to this another session of accounts. Today we will be taking up example 4 of your textbook, page 32. From the following trial balance of Piyush and Arun, you are required to prepare trading and P&L account and a balance sheet as on that date. Trial balance is on 31st March 2019. Stock, it is opening stock. It will go in the trading account debit side. Purchases and salary. You see salary word is misprint over here. It should not have been there. So please cancel it. Strike it off. Purchases 80,000. There we can see on the credit side, no purchases return. So no adjustment. It will appear in the outer column trading account debit side. Salary, it is indirect expenditure. It will come in P&L account debit side. Wages, direct expenditure. It will come in trading account. Carriage, it is indirect expenditure. It will come in trading account. Royalties, direct expenditure, it will come in trading account. Freight, it is also indirect expenditure, it will come in trading account. If you are confused with any of the terms over here, refer to lecture number 5, in which I have discussed trading account in detail. Printing and stationery, indirect expenditure, 1050 P&L account debit side. Debtors, amount receivable, balance sheet, asset side. Furniture, asset, balance sheet, item. Leasehold property, the property which you have taken on lease. For the detailed discussion and detailed meaning, refer to lecture number 7, in which I have explained in detail the term of leasehold property. It is an asset. The property which you have taken on lease under an agreement, asset side, balance sheet item. Investment, obviously it is asset, balance sheet item. Traveling expenses, indirect expenditure, 3,450. Advertisement, 3 year. So the type of adjustment this is hidden adjustment. For this year, for the year ending 2019, we will write in P&L account expenditure for 12 months. That is for 1 year, and 2 years expenditure, it is prepaid. So prepaid part will appear in balance sheet, asset side, and this year expenditure, P&L account debit side. Bad debt, indirect expenditure, it will come in P&L account debit side. Discount allowed, indirect expenditure, it will come in P&L account debit side. Cash in hand and bank, obviously they are asset, balance sheet items. Fixed deposit, again it is an asset, balance sheet, it will appear in balance sheet. Then credit side, Piyush and Arun, capital balances, they will be transferred to their capital account. Sundry debtors, it is in liability, it will appear in the liability side. Interest received on fixed deposit, it is income. Which income, direct or indirect? It is indirect income. So it will appear in P&L account credit side. Bank overdraft, it is in liability. It will appear in the liability side in the balance sheet. Then sales, it is a direct income trading account credit side. So we have seen all the items of trial balance. Now let us see adjustment. Stock in hand as on 31st March 2019 was cost price is 40,000 and market price is, so stock is always valued at cost or market, whichever is lower. So lower of the value we will take, and this we will write in the trading account credit side and balance sheet asset side. Interest on fixed deposit is still receivable. So this interest you have received and this is still receivable. So you will add 1200 in interest received. And the second effect will go in the fixed deposit. Asset side, you will add the interest receivable in the fixed deposit. So fixed deposit, you highlight it. Then provide RDD at 2.5% on debtor. Old RDD are not given anywhere. So you will, the RDD given in the adjustment, new RDD. So you will add this to bad debt. And the next second effect will go in the debtors. You will have to subtract RDD from the debtors. Depreciate furniture. So you will have to deduct depreciation from the furniture and show the depreciation amount in the P&L account debit side. Go destroyed 8,000 by fire and insurance company admitted a claim of 6,000. 8,000 rupees good were destroyed. 6,000 you have received from the insurance company. So the loss is of 2,000. It is an indirect loss. It will appear in the debit side of P&L account. 6,000 is claim receivable. It will appear in the balance sheet asset side. 8,000 good destroyed by fire. It will appear in the credit side of trading account. For detailed discussion, you refer to lecture number 5, wherein I have explained in detail. Here also, while doing the sum, once again I will explain. Now we shall start doing the sum, taking all the items one by one. So let us see. First is opening stock. Opening stock will appear in the debit side of trading account. So opening stock. The amount is 30,800. Then purchases. No adjustment is there. Straight away we can write in the outer column. To purchases. It is 80,000. Then salaries. It is an indirect expenditure, 5,000. P&L account. To salaries, 5,000. Next is wages, 7,500. Next is carriage, 3,000. After carriage, it is royalty. It is again an direct expenditure to royalties, 2,500. Then freight, 700 rupees freight to Then printing and stationery, it is an indirect expenditure, P&L account to printing and stationery, 1,050. Then debtors, we have highlighted, means some internal, some adjustment is there, external adjustment is there. So we will write it in the inner column, 43,000. Then after debtors. What is the adjustment in the debtors? 2.5% on debtors. RDD you have to provide. So RDD we have to add in bad debt, but the bad debt has still not come. So we calculate this amount on debtors. Later on, when the debtors come, we will add it. 2.5%, how we have to calculate, I will explain you. 43,000. 43,000, 2.5% is equal to 43,000 into 2.5 upon 100. So it is 1,000. You see what the student do? It is 2.5. Don't make it. It is 43,000 into 2.5 upon 100. Dear student, do not make it 25. Upon 100, it is 2.5 upon 100. Some of the students make it 25. So then the answer come wrong and the entire calculation is wrong. So 43,000 into 2.5 upon 100. Okay. So 1075. So 1075 is the 1075 is the RDD you have to deduct it. You have to deduct it plus RDD. And this RDD will be added in the bad debt. Add RDD and this we will have to add it in the 1075. When the bad debt amount will come, we will write over here. So we have given both the effect of RDD. Then after debtors, furniture. Furniture depreciation is there. We have highlighted it, 20,200. So furniture furniture 20,200 less depreciation 20,200 2,000. The depreciation rate is, I believe, 5%. So 5% we will write over year is equal to 20,200 into 5%. It is 1,010. So 1,010, we will write over 1,010 and the amount over here will be 20,200 minus 1,010 and this amount we will write in the P&L account. Depreciation amount we will write in the depreciation on furniture. The amount is 1,010. Okay. Then leasehold property. Leasehold property is an asset. We have taken the property on lease, 25,000. So leasehold property. Leasehold property. It is 25,000. Then we have investment 15,000. Investment 15,000. It is 15,000. Traveling expenses, indirect expenditure, P&L account debit side. Traveling expenses. Traveling expenses 3450. So traveling is 3450. Okay. And advertisement is 30,000. Indirect expenditure. to advertisement 30,000. There is an adjustment over here. You have not highlighted it. Okay. There is an adjustment. It is hidden 3 years. So, working note, how much we have paid? 30,000. We have paid 30,000 for 3 years. So, for 1 year, the expenditure is 30,000 divided by 3, it is 10,000. So, 10,000 is for 1 year. This we will write in this year. P&L account, debit side, and 30,000 minus 10,000 is prepaid. So this we will write is equal to 30,000 minus 10,000. So 20,000 is prepaid. This prepaid is an asset, balance sheet. Asset side we will write, and 10,000 this year expenditure. So advertisement less prepaid. Prepaid is 20,000. It means 10,000 is this year expenditure, and this prepaid we will write in balance sheet. Prepaid advertisement. How much it is? 20,000. Okay. Then bad debt, indirect expenditure, 500 rupees year 2 bad debt. This is 500 rupees. We will year with 500 plus RDD 1575. This bad debt is given in trial balance. We need not deduct from the debtors. It has already been deducted. Then discount allowed, expenditure 1800 to discount allowed. To discount allowed, 1800. How much it is? 1800. Then cash in hand, cash at bank, fixed. All these three are balance sheet items. So we'll go in the balance sheet, cash in hand, cash at bank, and fixed deposit. You see, here 43,000 minus 1075. Okay, then how much is cash in hand? Let us see, 7,000 and 20,000. So cash in hand, 7,000 and 20,000. Cash in hand, 7,000. Fixed deposit, we have highlighted it. It means some adjustment is there. It is second. Fixed deposit, 1,200 is still receivable. And this effect will go at two places. One, we will add it in fixed deposit, 15,000 we will write in the inner column. So just a minute. Add interest. Interest receivable is 1200. So 1200 is the interest receivable, 16,200. And this interest receivable, we will have to add interest 1200. This we will, when we go across credit side, we will come across interest received. Interest received, we will write here total and write the amount. So fixed deposit we have covered. We have done all the adjustment of the debit side. Now let us come to the credit side of the trial balance. Piyush and Arun, capital account 80,000 by balance. By balance brought down 80,000. Then creditors, it is a liability 20,500. Balance sheet item, creditors 20,000. Creditors 20,500. Interest on received on fixed deposit. Is an income. Which income? Indirect income. Interest on fixed deposit. It will go in the interest on fixed deposit. It is 1,000 rupees. So in the outer column, 4,200,000 only, not 1,000 rupees. Bank overdraft, it is a liability, it will come in the balance sheet. Bank overdraft. Bank overdraft. The amount is 10,000. 10,000. Sales, direct income, trading account, buy sales. Buy sales. 1,20,000, I suppose. Okay, we have done with all these credit item, all the debit item. Now let us see the adjustment. Stock on hand. Cost 40, market price 35. So lower of this 35, we will take 35,000 two effect, one in trading account by closing stock 35,000. And the second effect will go in the balance sheet, closing stock. Is 5,000. Then interest we have done, interest receivable, RDD we have done, depreciation we have done, boat destroyed by fire and insurance company admitted a claim of 6,000. I'll explain you. Let us go in our working note. Boats were destroyed worth 8,000 rupees. Insurance company has agreed to give us 6,000. So good burn 8,000, we will receive 6,000. So 8 minus 6,000, 2,000 is our loss. This is a loss, this is indirect, though it will go in P&L account. What all insurance company is going to give us, it is known as claim receivable. What it is known as? Claim receivable. So claim, we have to receive something, it is known as claim receivable. It is an asset, it will come in the balance sheet asset side. And this 8,000, goods destroyed. It will go, we will have to reduce our expenditure of what all expenditure we have written in trading account. We will have to reduce our expenditure by 8,000. So it will come in the credit side of trading account. So first effect, credit side, this we should write in the last, and here by good destroyed by fire, by good destroyed by fire, it was 8,000. Detailed discussion, refer to lecture number 5 and 7. Also in P&L account. Those are the basic lectures, please. Then out of this 8,000, our loss is loss by 5. How much was the loss? 2000. And how much we have to receive from the insurance company? Claim receivable. Claim receivable is 6000. So all the adjustment we have done. Now let us balance our accounts. Total of this side, let us do the total of this side is equal to sum. This side total comes to 163. And out of 163, this side total is 124,500. 124,500. So out of this, this minus this. So 38,500. This is the credit side total. This is the debit side total. So credit side is bigger. Out of this total, we minus debit side total. We get a gross profit of 38,500. Clear? To gross profit. This gross profit we will carry to P&L account. Here we have to write total. Here also we will have to write total. This we will delete. Now this gross profit we will write over here. By capital gross profit. How much? 38,500. Now here let us do the sum is equal to SUM. This side it will be 40,000. Out of this we will have to subtract all inner things we have written in the calculation we have made in the outer side. So we will make the total of this. It is 25,885. So out of this we will have to subtract this. It is 14,815. This is net profit. So to net profit, this net profit we will have to distribute to the partners. 14,815. What is their share? Let us see. You are required. Nothing is given over here. Let us see in the adjustment if anything is given below. Nothing is given about the share of profit. So when nothing is given, what is the ratio? Tell me. It is 50-50. It is 50-50. So each one of will get 50% is equal to this into 50%, it is 7408. So the other one will get this minus this. You see, it is being you see. Let me delete it. One will get this, so we round it off 7408. So the other person will get 7407. How we got this? Out of this we have subtracted you share, so you will get Arun share. Okay, so this we will write in the partners capital account and in the P&L account, 74 to net profit to Piyush, 7408 and 7407, Piyush and Arun, net profit transfer to this and this. So the total will be 14815. Okay. $40,700 and here $40,700. Okay. So here we will write total here also we will write total. Let us once again check this 40,700 and here also. So now we will transfer this profit to the partner's capital account by P&L account. How much it is? 7407. So okay, it is. Now we will total it 87407. Now we will write the balance over here to balance CD. And here we will write 87407. Okay. Then we will make the total 87408, 87407. And here we will write total. Total and here also total. So these balances we will transfer in the balance sheet, liability side, partners capital account. Partners capital account. How much is it? 87408. We will have to write there individual name, Piyush and Arun. Okay. This one is 87408 and this one is 87407. The total we will write in outer column, this plus this. Now we have completed all the things. Now let us do the total of balance sheet is equal to sum. The total comes to 2,05,315 asset side. Now let us do the sum of this side also. It comes to 2,05,315. Both sides have tallied. So all our working is 2,05,205,315. So the balance sheet have tallied to a extent, to that extent. Total. So easily you see we have done completed the sum. Please practice it. Now just a minute. You see there are 10 solved sum in your textbook. In the today's lecture I have completed 6 sum. I have completed 6 sum. Now we have remained with 4 more sums. So these four sums easily we can do in the next 8 to 10 days. So by 15th we will complete by all your 10 sum, and we are going at a moderate speed, neither fast neither slow. So you see in this chapter 15 marks practical question comes for sure. I am having with me your last year question paper, your last year question paper. 15 mark question is compulsory, and in the objectives, in the objectives 3 marks objectives come. So 15 and 3 18 total. Out of 80 mark we will be completing by 15, and this is the fundamental chapter. This is the fundamental chapter. On it the rest of the chapters are based. So once you are through with this chapter, I think what the point I was trying to, this is 18 marks out of total marks 80. So by 15th or 17th of this month we will be completing 22% of your course. This is a fundamental chapter on which other chapters are also based. So by and large in the month of by 17th 18th we will complete this chapter. Then previous paper discussion we will conduct in another 4-5 lectures. So safely in the month of June we will be done with your 22% it is showing, 22.5%, but safely you can say 20%, that is 1/5 of your syllabus you will be completing in the month of June. Then we are left with July, August, September, October, November. So easily in the next 5 months we can complete your entire syllabus. But simple completing it from my side will not help. Please practice the sums at your end also, so you get a hang of all the things. So please keep on studying, and if any problem you come across, kindly WhatsApp me. My WhatsApp number is here, my mail ID I have also given, so you can let me know your problems, they will be answered. So keep studying and stay home, stay safe. Thanks for watching. Also help your family by doing small